everyone, welcome to Botany Insider. So this is the very first lecture of our new series on the unit number 5, that is developmental biology. In this particular unit, we'll be having a complete introduction about that what developmental biology is, and also we'll be understanding about the various subtopics about that what is cell fate, what is a stem cell, what are the various potencies of a cell. So watch this complete video and have a good grip over this particular introduction portion. But before starting the video, if you haven't yet joined me on the Telegram channel, so search Botany Insider or just use the link given below in the description box. And in addition, if you are new to my channel, so do not forget to subscribe to my channel. So this was all. Now let's get into the video. So now, the very first point is that when we are looking into the word developmental biology, so there is a word called development in it. First of all, we need to understand about that what development is all about. We are about to start a unit, but we need to have a good understanding over this particular word itself. That is, what is the meaning of the name of the unit. So the name is development. So development in very simple word means the progressive changes in the size, in the shape, in the function during the life of an organism. That is, in development, what happens is the size, shape, and the function of a particular organism changes progressively, by which there occurs the changes in the genetic potentials. That is, how that particular person is going to function. This is what changes during the course of the development. So this is what development is all about. Now, the very first point is that for development, or before that itself, we know that humans start off their life by the help of a zygote or a single celled. So this is the very first cell from which a complete human being is produced. Now, how this zygote gets developed into a complete human and what are the stem cells? So we need to understand, or we need to have a correlation between them. So stem cell, what is a stem cell? So the stem cells are the special human cells that are able to develop into different types of the cell types. That is, initially we have a zygote. This is the single cell from which a human initiates its life. Now, this single cell gets converted or gets developed into various progressive stages into a complete human being. Now, this human have various functions to perform. It have various different types of human cells. How this zygote gets converted into this particular human being is how, or it is because of the presence of the stem cells. So there are stem cells present. So these stem cells are the special human cells because of which zygote first divides and then it differentiates, it specializes into various types of cells. And because of that, what happens is this human is able to perform the various functions of its life. This can range from muscle cell to the brain cell. We have various type of cells in our body, like the muscle cells or the brain cells. All of these are produced from the stem cells itself. In some of the cases, they can also be used to fix the damaged tissues. Now, we can say that the stem cells are the body's raw material. That is, they are the cell from which all the other cells with the specialized functions are generated. Under the right conditions in a body or in the laboratory, the stem cells could divide to form more cells called as the daughter cells. So when a single cell divides into two cells or into the four cells, depending upon which division it is occurring or which division it is undergoing, it produces the daughter cells. So when there are right conditions in the body or the complete process is occurring in the laboratory conditions, the stem cell could divide to form more than one or more forms of the cells, which are given the name of the daughter cells. So this was about it. Let's move forward. Now, these daughter cells either become the new stem cells, that is the self-renewal, or they become specialized cell with more functions. such as the blood cells, brain cells, heart cells or the bone cells. Now what does this mean? Let's just quickly understand about this. So consider we have a stem cell. So this is a stem cell that we have initially. Now this stem cell could divide into two conditions. When the right condition is there, it could divide either into two different type of daughter cells, or the other way around is this stem cell divide into first the complete cell, that is first the daughter cell that we had would be of the same stem cell, and the second would be performing a function. Why it is required? Reason being, this stem cell, if continue to divide and form only the specialized cell, it would end up, or the body would end up losing all the stem cell at one point of time in the life. So in order to have some copies of the stem cells produced, or some copies of the stem cells still remaining in the body, for that matter, self-renewal is very important. So this is what is written over here, that is the stem cell could either become the new stem cell, that is self-renewal, or it could either become the specialized cell. Now when a cell gets specialized into a different type of cell, this is what is given the name of differentiation. So now we will be understanding about that, what is speciation, what is differentiation, in a bit. So remember about that, what differentiation is all about, from this particular slide, and we'll be having a more elaborative discussion in the further video. Now the stem cell, see, this is what a stem cell looks like. When it is cultured, it can get converted into the various types of cell, like the nerve cell, blood cells, liver cells or the muscle cells, depending upon the conditions required, or depending upon what are the various possibilities for this particular cell. Now we have the classification, or we have the potency. What do we mean by potency? If we look at this word in normal English language, potency means the, in Hindi we could call it shamta, that is a cell, or what is the actual possibility, or what are the actual capabilities that a particular cell possesses. So this is what is potency all about. We have four main potencies. The first one is monopotency, second one is multipotency, third one is pluripotency, and the fourth one is totipotency. Now we'll understand about each one of them. So if we look into the figure, totipotency, as the word suggests, total. Total means when a cell is capable of dividing into each type of new cell. This is what totipotency is all about. The second one is pluripotency. What is pluripotency? So a cell which could divide into all the ones except a few. What are those? We'll understand in a bit. Third one is multipotency, that is when one cell could divide into or get converted into many types. And last one is unipotency, that is when one cell could convert into a single type. Let's look into the definitions and then we'll have a better understanding. The first one is totipotent. Totipotent means that these stem cells can differentiate into all the possible cell types. The first few cells that appear as the zygote starts to divide are the totipotent. That is, initially we have some cells, and these cells, that is after the zygote, we have some of the cells which could divide into all the new types, or every type of cell could be produced from those cells. This is what totipotency is all about. Remember it this way, T for totipotency and T for total. Total means all. So when a cell could have, or when a cell have the possibility to divide into all the possible cell types. The second one is the pluripotency. Pluripotency is that when a cell could turn into almost every cells. Cells from the early embryo are pluripotent. So when a cell could convert into almost every cell but not embryo, this is what a pluripotent cell is all about. Third one is multipotent. So multipotent is that these cells can differentiate into a closely related family of cells. That means that initially, let's consider we have this particular cell. So consider we have this cell, and this cell could divide into, let's say this is a stem cell and this stem cell have a totipotency. That means it could divide into any number of type or any number of functions it wants to perform. Let's say it have converted into 4 types of cell. This cell could convert into the brain cell. Let's have just assumption for the same. These cells could convert into the liver cells. These cells could convert into the muscle cells. And these cells could convert into the nerve cells. So this is what a totipotent cell is all about. Next we have a pluripotent cell. So what is a pluripotent cell? So when a cell could divide into all or almost all the types except the embryo, this is what a pluripotent cell is. Next we have multipotent. Multipotent is that when a cell could convert into the same cell lineages. What does this mean? So consider we have this cell. Now we are understanding about the multipotent. So let's say this is a cell and this is a multipotent stem cell. This stem cell, let's say this multipotent cell is for the blood cells. So this multipotent blood cell could convert into either the WBC, that is the white blood cells, or the RBC or the red blood cell. It could either convert into the platelets. So this multipotent stem cell, this cell have a cell lineage of the blood cells. This multipotent could convert into all the families or all the sub members of the blood cells only. This blood cell or this multipotent cell cannot give rise to a brain cell type. So this is what a multipotent cell is all about, in which the cell could give rise to the same cell lineages. The last one is about the unipotent. Unipotent in the word itself suggests one single type. So when one WBC could convert into many WBC of its own type, in this not the cell lineage, only the specific type matters. Second one is the RBC. So when one RBC could divide and convert into many of its own form, this is what a unipotent cell is all about. I hope you have got the difference between the 4 of them. So we have the next one as the multipotent, as we have just discussed, in which the cell can differentiate into a closely related family of the classes. The last one is the unipotent. So unipotent are the ones which can produce the cells of one kind, which are of their own type. Now the embryonic stem cells, this is a simple note you have to remember, that the embryonic stem cells could be considered pluripotent and not the totipotent. Reason being, they cannot become a part of the extra embryonic membrane or the placenta. So remember about this, that the embryonic stem cells are pluripotent and not totipotent. So this was about the potency of the various stem cells. I hope this topic is clear. Reason being, many times questions have been asked from this area in both the DBT and the JRF. So the next topic is about the cell fate. Now, what is a cell fate all about? In simple words, a cell fate means that when a cell divides, what are the possibilities into which it could convert? That is, if we have a cell and this cell divides, so what are the possibilities or what are the various types in which it could convert? This is what cell fate is all about. So the fate of the cell is all of the different type of the cell types its descendants can become during the normal development. So we have a cell. So what are the possibilities or all the possibilities into which this particular cell type could convert? This is what a cell fate is all about. So the cell fate becomes more restricted until a cell is terminally differentiated. What does this mean? We'll understand in a bit. So the example for this is, let's consider we have a cell and this cell, let's say it is a pluripotent cell and it could convert into first the kidney cells, next the brain cells and the liver cells. So the property or the possibility of this particular cell to convert into the various types, this is the cell fate for this particular cell. So this was about it. Now let's understand about one more term, and that is commitment. Now what is commitment? So the fate of the cell or the possibility of the various types of the cell that could be produced, this is what is decided, or this is what is done by the commitment. That is, commitment decides the fate of the cell, of the cell to a specific induction and their capacity to develop into a particular kind. That is, what induction that cell have got, what is induction. So we'll be having a detailed lecture for this. For the time being, just remember, induction in simple word means the signal. So what the signal that particular cell have received, and what is the capacity of this cell to convert into a particular kind, this is what commitment is all about. And after the induction and after its perseverance, we get the decision of the fate of the cell. Now, there are two stages of commitment. That is, for a cell to convert into the different type and deciding its fate, it requires commitment, because commitment decides the fate of cell. And for commitment, there are two specific stages. The first one is the specification. That is, the first, that is, the cell first get specified, and after that the cell gets determined, or there occurs determination. What does this mean? Let's understand. The first one is specification. So what is specification? As the word suggests itself, that the cell gets specified for a specific fate. That means the development of the differentiated cell type into the different in the function, cell shape, internal structure. That is, we have a cell and it gets specified into a specific function for a specific cell shape and the internal structure. This is the labile phase. What does this mean? I'll let you explain in a minute. Next is that the cell which do not have a fixed fate, that is, this particular cell is still not, or it is not in the final phase of its commitment. It is still in its labile phase. It could revert back to the original position. How? We'll understand. It can revert back from its fate, and in this, the commitment, or in the specification phase, the commitment is reversible. Remember about these points. The second point is about the differentiation. That is, the second stage is the differentiation. So differentiation is the process in which the cell actually gains its function, and it depends on the protein that is synthesized. The process by which the cell becomes fully functional and structurally specialized. That is, now the specification, or now the complete commitment is being completed, and now this cell is determined that yes, it would form a specific type only. The process by which the cell tissues or the organs acquire a specialized feature, especially during the embryonic development. Let's understand these all points altogether, and then we'll have a better understanding for the same. So consider, initially this is the first cell, and this cell is undifferentiated. What does this mean? That this cell do not have any specific function to perform. So this is a undifferentiated cell. Now we have just understood that for a specific cell which is undifferentiated to convert into a cell which have a specific function to perform, it requires one thing, and that is commitment. And for commitment, it would end up in deciding the fate of the cell. And for commitment, we require two stages. The first stage is specification, and the second stage is determination. The specification stage is labile, that is, it is the initial stage. Let's understand this. Now we have the undifferentiated cell. This cell gets specified to convert into the brain cell, let's say. So this is the first stage, and that is the specification stage. So here we have the specification. Now, after this specification stage, what happens is that there occurs some signal induction. This induction was of less concentration in the initial phase, but now there occurs more specification, and this cell after the specification become determined to get converted into the brain cell itself. So then we have the determination phase, and finally this determined cell gets converted into the differentiated cell into the brain cell itself. Now, what happens is initially we had the undifferentiated cell. This cell initially went into the first stage. It got some induction to a lower level and it got converted, or it had a specificity that it would be converting into the brain cell. But at this point also, there are high chances that this specified cell could revert back to the original one, that is to the undifferentiated one. But then there occurs more of the induction, or more inductive signal appears, because of which this specified cell then become determined, or this particular cell have more commitment towards the conversion into the brain cell, and then this determined cell gets finally converted into the brain cell, and now this brain cell is what we call as the differentiated. That is, now it have a specific function to perform, it have got its specific role to perform, and that is to function as a brain cell. So this is what specification determination is all about, and this is the difference between the undifferentiated cell and the differentiated cell. Now there is one more important thing, that is, initially we have the undifferentiated cell, then we had the specified cell, after that we had the determined cell, and finally the differentiated cell. So from the undifferentiated cell towards the differentiated cell, there occurs increase of commitment. What does this mean? That is, there occurs more of the possibility that the fate of the cell is confirmed. That means, in other words, we have this undifferentiated cell having the specificity that it would be converting into the brain cell. So in the initial phase of specificity, there are chances that this cell could revert back to the original undifferentiated cell. But as and when the inductive signal concentration increases, and as and when the specificity stages increases towards the differentiated stage, there occurs more of commitment and also less chances of reversibility. So in this particular thing, we can understand, when we mark an arrow towards the differentiated cell, there occurs more of commitment and also less chances of reversibility. Remember this very nicely. Reason being, in exam, questions are framed from these areas itself. You need to have a good understanding of the same. I'm trying to make it as simple as possible for you all. So just remember. So the specified cell, which is in the specification phase, have more chances of reversibility. Hence, we have just called it as a labile phase. But in the determined phase, or the determined cell, in this, the fate is specified and the cell is now ready to commit into a specific cell function, and that is the brain cell in this particular example. So this was all about all the topics, or the initial introduction about the developmental biology. I hope this video was helpful for you. I've tried to make this topic as simple as possible. This is a bit tricky, but just go through this video once or twice for your better understanding, and you're good to go for this particular topic. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If yes, do let me know in the comment sections below, and also do not forget to like, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. In addition, join me on Telegram as well for the free mock test, and also for the daily updates of all the videos. So thank you so much, everyone, for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.